I was hungry and the pig knew it and the pig respected everything that went on. The pig gave its consent.
The pig gave it consent!
The pig knew what was happening. It knew this day would come. To the pig, this is like a holy rite of ascension. To the pig, this is like heaven's gate. The pig believes it's moving on.
The pig's been going to church with you. You've been taking the pig to church. It's been listening.
The pig understands. The pig, while probably couldn't explain it to you, implicitly understands the whole cosmology of, you know, the Dark Ages. Welcome to Mandatory Redistribution Party. I am christened Sean Morley.
Salutations, brethren. I am christened Jack Lewis Evans.
Today's liturgy comes from the Book of Mandos.
And if ye derive merriment from this sermon, I implore thee to pledge thy allegiance at patreon.com/mandatoryredistributionparty. In return, we shall bestow our eternal gratitude and shower thine ears with thick ambrosia.
Now, as ever, upon the completion of the liturgy, please return to your communities to spread the word of Pod, either verbally over a congealed ale or quilled in holy ink upon the community notice board.
Politics is fucked, right?
Oh yeah, hard agree.
We live in a democracy, right?
Uh-huh.
But we don't, because it's largely a two-party system that just maintains the illusion of democracy while obscuring the fact that, you know, all the major parties uphold capitalist interests and are just a kind of facade.
What determines the vote? It's what people believe, and their beliefs are based on what information you have access to. And because the United Kingdom has no, like, free and open media, and it's it's more and more of an oligarchy, it's highly corrupt, the revolving door between media companies and the politicians. It's just a little group of friends writing posts, and we get to read them.
And they've all got like second jobs where they're getting paid £15,000 by the Sewage in the Rivers is Good Corporation.
The one-armed bandit LTD sponsors the Labour Party.
I've got a solution.
Yeah?
It's called feudalism.
Is this a new idea? Is this yours, is it?
It's new.
Jack
it's
Evans my TM.
I've come up
this
with
Dragon's
this.
Den.
So I've come up with this feudalism, and here's my idea.
Okay.
The copyright.
Okay, I've got my arms folded. I'm looking quizzical into the middle distance.
The current system's like an elected dictatorship, right? Why don't we reveal the truth? Why don't we reveal the naked class power? Monarch.
This is similar to an idea I had where it would be good to just be ruled by like a big alien or a big supernatural force that you couldn't do anything
yes.
about.
Yes, yes. A supernatural force with the divine right to rule.
Oh, that would be nice. Yeah, I was thinking like an alien or a robot, but actually if someone's been inspired by God, the All-Father, the creator of all, that's probably even more locked down because you could conceivably turn a robot off or tell an alien to go home.
And I think it's clear. You're not like, oh, what's this person acting on behalf of? No, no. The king is acting in the interests of the king.
Mm.
And they're trained to be king.
Yeah, you haven't just got some random.
What does Rishi Sunak know about anything?
In an election, most people don't win. So that's a lot of wasted energy.
Yes, yeah.
That's a lot of posters. That's going in the bin.
It's not green.
A lot of people putting ticks on bits of paper. Mm-hmm. Is that getting recycled? I'm not so sure.
Mm-hmm.
Whereas here, king, just one king, done. Bish, bish, bish.
We're all struggling over it. People are like, oh, can we get this party in? This sort of compromise would be slightly better if, you know, there's slightly less shit than them. Oh, shall I go door knocking? No. Just don't think about it.
Yeah.
Then you can concentrate on other stuff. That's good for the country because you've got someone who they're born. We know they are going to rule. Train them up. Yeah. Train them up. Build up their expertise. And also they're being trained to rule. It's not like the monarchy we have now. Charles is just trained to be like a PR guy and have sausage fingers. And he's not even good at that. Well, he's good at the latter.
He's very good at having sausage fingers.
He's very good at having sausage fingers.
World leader.
But you train them up to be like good at doing king stuff. Like
twirling a scepter.
Yeah, having a scepter.
Like a majorette.
Touching lepers every now and then. supposedly to heal them.
Oh, you could have him sat on a throne in a great hall.
Yeah.
And it's kind of like numinous and dark, but then a little peak of light comes in and it's a guy in kind of like burlap, rough materials. His fingernails are like blackened with the earth.
Sire, I bring terrible news from the borderlands.
Terrible famine. Me and my large family are all bent double with the sickness. And the king can say, be gone. And the slight rattling of the king's guard's swords as they go to their scabbards with the implicit threat, just try it, peasant. That could play out 24 times a day.
Sire, there's discontent in the north. The northern lords have refused to pay their taxes. Kill them all.
All dead.
All killed.
Kill anyone in regions proximate to these lords. Kill our own men. Kill the people who killed the lords so there are no witnesses. Then kill them. None of this gets to the people who live in this city.
And then, in the same chamber, again, in a piece of clarity, we have, in our modern world, we have shows like Have I Got News For You? And Mock the Week, although that's been cancelled, which appear to be like, we're mocking the powerful.
Yeah, what's wrong with a little jester?
Exactly, the jester's clear.
Yeah, and the jester knows, if I go, oh, the king's an arsehole, that's it. They're going to boil me feet first, you know?
Yeah.
Listen, which of these two worlds is better, right? One, you get up every day to grow a turnip. Mm. But once every 4 years, you've got to spend 3 months being like, oh, I've got to make a big decision. But then you make the decision and nothing happens. Everything's exactly the same, if not worse. Or you just keep growing the turnip.
If David Baddiel and Matt Ford have to be dancing around covered in bells.
Yeah.
I think it makes things clear.
If you've got the best entertainers in the country dressed as a little elf doing a fart for the aristocracy, you're not going to get them as talking heads later being like, I speak truth to power. This is actually the most important art form. I've been cancelled when my head was chopped off by the king. Can't tour after that. Cancelled means cancelled.
Cancelled. D-platform's not happening. Beheaded.
Yeah. Yeah, you actually go onto a platform. It's the gallows.
Yeah, if someone starts saying, do you want to be platformed? Don't say yes.
No, deplatform me.
I want to get off the platform, please.
Yeah, as the ropes go around their neck, please, can the student movement deplatform me? Can the city intellectuals please deplatform me?
I tell you what as well, with our current system, people, you're like, oh, we'll get to vote these out. 5 years, we'll get to vote these out, and then they'll be gone. But they won't be gone. Firstly, the people that are coming in aren't really meaningfully changing anything. They're people who are gone. What consequence is there for the crimes they've committed upon the people? Fuck all, Sean. How do you get rid of a monarch? The only way to get rid of a monarch is for either another monarch from another country to declare war and come and kill them, and then they become the monarch.
Yeah.
Option, the people in the country kill the monarch. And do you know what that is? That's consequences.
And democracy.
That's true democracy. That's not
democracy. That's direct democracy. Just stop oil could never.
Yeah. Worst case scenario for Rishi Sunak. Oh no, I've been voted out.
Time to live in my big house.
Time to die outside your big house on the platform.
Time to get platformed. Your term has come to an end. And the thing is, a king, right, doesn't have to appeal to anyone.
No.
So if there were like loads of just horrible dickheads who wanted absolutely incomprehensible stuff, the king could just be like,
no,
I'm the king. Oh, we want you to stop all trade with all neighbouring countries. Mm. The king could be like, that doesn't add up to me. No.
Sounds like a bad idea. No.
But we all want it. I don't care.
I don't give a shit. I've got divine
so
right.
What? Yeah. Look at this sword. Look, this is given to me by God.
Glistening scepter.
And I'm going to give it to your neck.
Sean, do you know what's just a huge problem in the modern world?
Just
food.
Yeah. I actually don't quite like food.
I like eating food, right? Because I need it to live. I need it to be sustained. However,
I like it on top of that, actually.
I like it's enjoyable.
Some of it, if I've got a nice piece of bread. I think I could nourish that all day in my cheeks like a hamster.
Have you encountered the person who just purely sees food as like petrol going in their body?
Are you going to tell me that there was Huel under feudalism?
No, what I am going to say
feudalism
is that, listen, look, it's as much as you and I enjoy food, we know that we exist as part of a system of industrialized agriculture, globalized agriculture that prioritizes profit over sustainability and well-being. And, you know, it's all, there's all this fucked diet culture bullshit that commodifies and exploits people's insecurities for financial gain. Farm labor is often insecure labor. Industrialized agriculture is causing deforestation and, you know, horrible animal cruelty. I've got a solution for you, Sean.
Okay.
Feudalism.
I grow a big turnip and I give most of it to the church.
You have to give some of the turnip to the church or possibly the Lord.
Or both.
Perhaps both.
It's nice to go from garden to table. And what I would say, you know, like big seed bank projects.
Yeah.
Do you know, it's not, it's kind of reassuring knowing that up in the abbey, there's going to be loads of pumpkins
They're
and squashes just in case. Yeah.
They're looking
Presumably,
after
if there was a flood or something, maybe you could have a little nibble on that. Or you could go and kill the abbot.
Yes.
And just get it all.
Take a step.
And he's been looking after it. You haven't had to do that labor.
Yeah.
You, the peasant, in a way, you're using the church as a warehouse, but for free. Because the priests are weak physically, aren't they?
They're eating. They've got some good food from somewhere.
Yeah, but they're not ploughing the fields,
they're
right?
They're not doing the labor. Yeah,
me and my eight brothers.
Yeah.
We like dragging two trees on our shoulders every day, right? Our arms are too big.
Yeah.
We're like beavers having to gnaw wood to keep them down. We need to start punching and hitting, otherwise our arms get too long and start dragging along the floor.
You're not necessarily going to do that to the men of God, right?
Okay.
Preservatives, not happening.
Yeah.
Pesticides, no. Everything's organic. You know, like you go to a shop and the organic thing is in a smaller package and it's more expensive.
Yeah, opposite will be true.
That's all you've got. That's what
no
you've got.
Packaging.
No
packaging.
Blister
packs.
No waste. No, none of that. Plastic. If you said to a peasant, is there a plastic wrapper for this? They would go, huh? What?
They would try to get you excommunicated.
Yeah. Get the sheriff.
Get the sheriff.
This man speaks of plastic. Devilry.
You know how all food is very tasty? And there's always like...
Back that off.
You go to the shops to get some paracetamol because you've not been sleeping and your joints feel like they're made out of glue.
Yeah.
Right? And you're going on and you see right next to the checkout, there's like a million fuse bars. You think, a fuse bar's back. I remember fuse bars. And that's it. You have to get a fuse bar. Under feudalism, nothing can tempt you because it tastes like shit.
You have to boil cabbage for half a day. And you know, people would complain about cabbage, but if you farmed it yourself and then had to boil it for half a day before you ate it, you would appreciate that.
All food would feel tasty because you'd just feel so tired by the time you've made it palatable that you're really ready for a hearty meal.
Yeah, you're really tired. You're really, really hungry. You've had to give some of it to the Lord. So it must be nice if the Lord wants it.
Must be good if the Lord wants it, yeah.
It must be nice.
The Lord's got good taste, probably eating loads of pheasants. Fuse bars.
You've probably got some common land that you're keeping.
Oh, that'll be nice.
Some animals on.
Can we do Punch and Judy on that?
Punch and Judy on the common land.
Is that all right?
No, the common land's for farming, Sean. You could do Punch and Judy in the house.
I thought it belongs to everyone. So by mass consent, if we all wanted a Punch and Judy.
I think...
people would say, we need that for food. It's been a hard winter. We need this patch. Yeah. Even this small, like 2 meters by 1 meter area, you want to set it up. Also, where are we going to stand? In with the pigs? In with the cabbages? How's this Punch and Judy going to work? And then the church is going, are you doing Punch and Judy? Sorry, we're going to send you prematurely to hell.
You know when, coming back to the church, it's difficult sometimes to choose what to eat, isn't it? Because of the tyranny of choice. On the one hand, the choice is reduced because you're getting what you've got in what's outside.
What grows here? Just cabbage.
Also, the church has issued diktats about what you are eating and when. You're not having meat on a Friday, for example.
Yeah.
Although there's that rule. It didn't say meat. It said forbidden four-footed flesh meat.
Yeah. Can't have the naughty ungulates before the weekend.
And they started eating birds because it's not four-footed. So it's like some pre-turkey thing. Can't remember its name. I want to say it's called a bustard.
You're telling me if we do feudalism, I can have a pre-turkey bustard on a Friday.
But they went extinct because people were like, here's the loophole meat.
Not just a loophole. They're probably pretty tasty. If everyone's eating bustard, people are going to know how to garnish that. You can have that on a bit of rye bread that tastes like a cinder block.
Well, I'll tell you what else went extinct. Beavers. Because people said it was a fish.
This sounds fun. You're playing loopholes, eating whatever you can find.
Yeah, getting around the church.
Is it four toes and above? Like if you found something with six toes, could you eat that? You could definitely argue it, right?
like a mutant.
Yeah, could I eat a mutant? And that's fun, right? You can be like, oh, what's happening? Oh, well, Friar Gregory's having a go at, like, Squab, the village idiot, because he's been eating a mutant. Yeah. And you're like, I don't need TV. I'll go to the mutant trials.
And also on food, you know, it was clear there's this, like, disconnect now. You know, meat is just in this weird plastic package, like a piece of Lego just on the shelf. And there's a disconnect, isn't there, between, like, the animal that's being killed for you to have that meat, the meat you're consuming. The horrors of animal slaughter should be made visceral. The city of London just completely banned butchers because of just, they were just dumping guts into the street.
Wow. So what, did they just not have access to meat because they banned the practice of butchery?
Then there's like a black market of butchers.
Subterranean butchers.
Subterranean butchers. But people were just, in the same way they were just, shit and piss was all over the street. The guts of animals, chicken guts, cow guts, sheep guts was just all over the street. You weren't allowed to sell meat by candlelight. It's because they wanted to see if there was like, if it was like riddled with something.
Such a, you know, in the years before electric light, the idea of being like, oh, this is gone. I will just set up a stall, like, in the first place, if someone's selling meat at night in the pitch black, that should be ringing alarm bells. Why are you not out with the day traders? Sorry, yeah, the cow took a long time to die, so I've got to market really late. I live all the way in Grimsby. This is the nearest I could do it. Anyway, do you want this haunch? It's not only that you have greater exposure to it, I think the horrors of mass slaughter and the machinification of like killing animals isn't even present, right?
Yeah.
You can have a lot of people, it's like, this pig's my best friend. I slept in the same bed as this pig for like 20 years. And when it went, I was hungry and the pig knew it and the pig respected everything that went on. The pig gave its consent.
The pig gave it consent!
It knew this day would come. To the pig, this is like a holy rite of ascension. To the pig, this is like heaven's gate. The pig believes it's moving on.
The pig's been going to church with you. You've been taking the pig to church. It's been listening.
The pig understands. The pig, while probably couldn't explain it to you, implicitly understands the whole cosmology of, you know, the Dark Ages. And the pig knows the natural order of things, just in the same way when you're lying on your deathbed, right, and you're going, oh, I'm slipping away, I'm old now, time to go. You're not there thinking, oh, someone should make a law about this. You're like, this is nature. This is natural. Shouldn't legislate against it. What do you mean? You know, I'm just dying. That's how the pig feels. The pig's there going, you know, I return to the earth now. Thank you, John, if that's your name. If your name's John, who'd think that?
A guy did actually, a guy got proper in trouble for selling pig meat. He just found a dead pig.
Because you need to be able to tell the story of that meat, right?
Yeah. And he got tied to a pillory, and I think with rotten meat tied to him, so birds sort of...
They do like poetic justice.
I think that's a smooth transition. So I think, Sean, you would agree there's a lot of problems with the justice system. Is it actually reforming people? The way punishment is... It's taken out, you know, people are just extracted from society and put in these, like, prisons.
You've got these magistrates who sit in front of a human being and hear their story and their reason for doing stuff and then pass judgment on them. Isn't that God's job?
Isn't that the job of people trained to judge morality?
Yeah. Mm. God. God's angels, the seraphim, cherubim, the nephilim, the lilim. All of these, you know, holy Abrahamic beings. Mm. You put on a wig on, you think, I'm not going to notice that you're human. You're just a guy. You can't tap into that.
Also, if the point of the prison system is to punish people, I think that punishment needs to be clear. I know about prisons in an abstract sense, but if I saw someone in stocks at the end of the road, that's clear.
And also you can go up to them and go, what's going on? You can't do that at prison.
What have you done, mate?
And then you understand the justice system. The problem is the justice system is siloed away. If I go up to a prison, they go, why do you want to come in here? Yeah. I want to go up to the prisoners and say, what's going on? Why are you in here? What's happening?
They'll say that's not valid.
They'll say that's invalid.
Yeah.
The stocks, it's not only valid, that's the point, isn't it? That's the whole point. You can go up to them and go, why are you in here? I've been away. I've gone to the next market town over with my sow. She's gone now.
Yeah.
Which is good.
Yes.
I've got some coins here. Half it will go on ale, I have a problem, but the rest of it's for my family. We might buy a bustard, split it. Anyway, last time I saw you,
I might
you
have made up the word busted. I'm just going to really apologize.
It's canon now. People know what we mean.
Yeah, yeah.
The language was far less centralized and fixed. Mm, people send everything all over the place.
Yeah.
If you go about 5 miles in any direction, you haven't got a clue what anyone's saying.
And that's good.
Okay.
Because it keeps it local. Because it keeps it local. Well, listen, right?
Yes.
If you think about news media, if you think about news media, what does news media do, right? It appears to be that we have free speech, etc., etc. But we know that the news media functions to manufacture consent. It promotes capitalist ideology. It maintains a concentration of power and wealth among media owners and suppresses alternative viewpoints and dissent. Uh-huh. So what's a better way that news should be conveyed? Town crier.
Yes. Someone's just very loud, but doesn't that give that person too much power?
Now you've got the 24-hour news, there's clickbait, you don't know what's... There's fake news all over the place. But if you see fake news, you know what you can't do? Go up to them and go, what?
Yeah, what are you on about?
Where did you find that out?
Yeah, why are you telling everyone on my street that? I know that's not true.
Yeah.
Give me that bell. Let me cry.
You're saying the well the next town over is poisoned.
Where have you got that from?
Well, everyone's dead. Everyone's dead in Welton.
It could have just been divine providence. Who ever thought of that? They could have been sinners.
Yeah, God smited them.
I think they're all doing adultery. And I saw someone worshipping a kind of bundle of twigs.
And then he goes, yeah, that makes sense, yeah.
Hear ye, hear ye. Yeah. The well is right out in Welton. Divine punishment from God. The king stubbed his toe in this region and they have been punished.
I like the idea that from one end of the town to the other, the news changes into something completely different based on the feedback of people coming out of their houses, offering their opinions. There is no consensus. That's democracy.
Yeah.
No one knows what's going on. That's equal.
And it also makes the local things matter. The town crier cares about you. He knows you.
And they're going to get good at telling great stories, but in short... In very short bursts, right? Because you've got to scream it. So that is, you've got Twitter.
You've got a more advanced version of Twitter.
He's got a character limit, literally, of how much he can say before he loses his voice. But also...
The bell is the blue tick.
Yeah, there's also a limit of how many actual characters can participate in any of these stories because we only know about 15 people.
Mm.
Llewellyn did this. Go, who's Llewellyn? Yeah, sorry. John from the Butchers did this. Oh, yeah, John. He did what?
And also, do you know how John became a butcher?
No.
Because...
I never thought I'd find this out. Now
because John's dad was probably a butcher.
Mm.
Do you know what? There's none of this like, oh, the facade that we live in a meritocracy. You're going to have to go see a careers advisor. You're going to look at the prospects.
Yeah.
No.
If you apply yourself and go to HMV with a CV, within 3 years, you'll actually be a traffic warden, your true dream. No. That's a sham. Just say, Dad, what are you doing? Okay, can you apprentice me in that?
Mum, are you weaving a tapestry?
Yeah. Do you want to learn?
No.
We're going to have to. This is the only thing we could do.
But also, you get to, at the end of it, which is nice, you'd be like, you build a thing beginning to end.
Mm.
Inefficient. It's inefficient to do it that way.
But you're not alienated from your labour, Sean.
Exactly. And you can chat to other people.
Yeah.
People can get together. They all do a task together.
You farmed that turnip. You planted it, you nourished it, you got it out of the dirt. You made that woolen coif with your hands.
Yeah, and I gift you this coif that I made from beginning to end. I brought it into this world. I did that, and it belongs to me.
Yeah,
and the other two belong to the church.
And do you know what you're not going to encounter?
You see the abbot walking around with two coifs on at once.
Do you know what you're not going to encounter in the fields as your brow glistens with sweat?
Yeah.
You're not going to encounter a peasant going, one day I shall be a lord.
You'd be like, no, you fucking won't, mate.
No, you fuck. What are you talking about?
How old are you? 28. You're going to die in a year.
Yeah. They're actually over life expectancy.
Yeah. You're a skeleton.
All right. Granddad's gone mad.
Yeah, this is dementia. The moment someone mentions anything that sounds like social mobility, you need to literally put them out into the pasture.
A 28-year-old peasant believes he can become a justice of the peace.
Yeah, is that the town crier?
Yeah, yeah.
A 28-year-old peasant believes he can become a justice of the peace in Welton. He has been platformed and killed. For the safety of the people.
You can see everyone opening the little hatches of their thatched roof cottages and laughing inside. You what?
Yeah, he's bloody mad. Good job, he's killed.
ding. Mad granddad killed. By decree of the Lord. It's just clear. I'm a blacksmith. I'm going to be a blacksmith forever, which by forever I mean my life expectancy of 26 years. I'll make a load of horseshoes and then I'll fucking die. And that's clear. That's simple.
Do you know what you don't have?
Yeah.
Under feudalism, imposter syndrome.
And do you know what you can't have? A midlife crisis.
Yeah.
Maybe I should change my career. No, you're probably dead.
Yeah, what should I do in my life? What are you doing right now? Yeah, done. Done. Bish, bash, bosh. Well, what's next in my life? Death.
Oh, but I worked really hard in school. Did you learn to read the Bible?
And do you read the Bible very much? No, no, not now. I just do my one trade. Oh, for how long? Just whenever the sun is up.
Oh, that's a good... Yeah, get fuck the tyranny of clocks. Alarm yeah. clock, horrible. What I want to hear is a rooster.
What I like is winter comes, it's too cold, just can't do anything.
Yeah.
Whole country comes to a standstill.
Yeah, it's bedtime.
It's just bedtime for 2.5 months.
Yeah. And the food, the horrible salted preserved food you've got is just getting more and more gross. But you know what? You don't feel bad because that's all we've fucking got.
You don't have to spend all that energy thinking about what else might be possible. There's only this reality. It's like probability hasn't been invented yet. What's going to happen? Just the thing that's going to happen. And what if something else happened? I literally don't understand what you've just said.
I think there's a lot of benefits to not knowing what the fuck's going on. Do you know, like, ignorance is bliss, right? We know the education system perpetuates class division by favouring the wealthy while also indoctrinating students with capitalist ideology and discouraging critical thinking, etc., etc. Burdening the university system burdens working class people with student debt, while middle class people can just pay it off and they never have to worry about the interest, etc., etc., right?
Uh-huh.
Feudalism. Here's a better education system than our education system. Nothing.
Yeah, just nothing.
Just nothing.
If it's important, you'll figure it out.
If it's important, they'll fucking tell you on church on a Sunday.
Well, your parents already told you.
Yeah.
And if you've been orphaned, then someone will take you in and they'll just tell you and then put you in the field.
If you need to learn something, your mum's going to just lean down to you and go, a beaver's a fish, so we can eat it, actually.
Yeah, now eat up.
Eat your beaver.
Eat your beaver. Back out into your field. All right, welcome to school. Do you know how to drive this crude implement into the soil? No? There you go. Goosh. Can you do that? Yeah.
Here's your diploma.
You've graduated. Yeah. Yeah. We'll get all the family around. You've graduated. Full honours. BA soil.
Or you need to be able to plough. You need to be able to count chickens and other livestock.
And I tell you what, you get to be incredibly superstitious. You get to live in this world where all the old pagan beliefs are still there in the background and you can't bring them up, but you can say there's just random shit you're inexplicably scared of, right? You can't say, I believe in this kind of fawn that lives in the forest. They'll platform you. But you can say, oh, I believe if I see, you know, a grey-spotted bustard on a Thursday, then the turnips are going to die. You're sort of allowed to do that. So you can be scared of random shit. And that, for people who want to live inside a Harry Potter universe with magic, that really happened, you know?
Yeah.
And it's also grassroots
mythology building, you know? You get to think of it. You get to create the lore.
And it's only built over what other people are saying, right? So do you like D&D? Mm. Well, imagine that you're doing D&D in the workplace all day long. You can only express it through being afraid of very specific phenomena.
You're really playing D&D and you're a very, very low level character.
Yeah, it's more just dungeons. What's your class? Peasant. Okay, and what's the party? We're all peasants here. And what's your quest? Just live a good, honest life in the eyes of God.
Subsistence.
Yeah, subsistence farming.
Yeah, and avoiding the eternal fires of hell.
Yeah.
By obeying the Lord.
Yeah. Roll for dexterity.
Yeah, there's no telly, there's no video games, but you can have a good time without them. Jousting. You can go and see a lord hit another lord off a horse and kill him.
Yeah.
You can see that.
And there isn't enough infrastructure or stadiums for that event to be adequately ticketed.
Yes.
You can just go.
You can see, and it has to be a lord, because they're not letting you have armor on a horse.
Yeah, you'd be off.
You're not having that. You'd be platformed.
You'd take that to the next town, you'd sell them, you'd buy a very big beer, and you'd never be seen again.
Yeah, so you get to see a member of the ruling class kill another one. Not in fiction, not in, oh, I'm watching it in 4K, this is all very well written. No, you get to see the Lord of Humberside drive a blade into the skull of the Baron of Krunk.
So all those people who were talking about PMQs going, oh, we landed an astonishing blow there.
Fuck off. Get fucked.
Did they have a lance? Yeah. If someone comes to PMQs with a lance,
yeah,
fair fucking play.
I want to see a 22-year-old nobleman club another one to death.
I want to see a dashing young knight with beautiful auburn locks,
yes,
wink at a princess, put a rusty metal helm on his head, and then immediately have a broadsword go through the slats of that helmet through their skull.
And I want to hoot and holler and clap.
Yeah, I want to just completely lose control of my body in an ecstasy of gore.
And hear that's just ye, what I hear do. Ye. Yeah. The Lord has got wrecked.
Yeah, the Lord of Dewsbury was owned.
Grassroots music as well. You know, we've got all these problems with venues. All the people in the fucking charts are, they're already all aristocrats who went to private school. Get someone on a fucking lute. Get someone, some local person playing, I don't know, just hitting a pan down the tavern. Traveling minstrels.
They're the ultimate ice cream man. You only hear the ice cream man, you're like, you know, it's not often that hearing a random piece of music through your single glazed windows heralds anything. Almost never, really. It's either going to be the ice cream man's here, or if you live in certain parts of Northern Ireland, the paras have come round.
Or
it could be rag and bone man.
Yeah.
And some people say they got a knife sharpening man. Even now, there's a knife sharpening man who comes round. But here, you hear just a little bit of loot. You're like, fucking bards here.
Yeah, bards come.
There's a bard in town.
And they just straight out.
You just travel to where the loot is. Yeah. You just listen to him.
And also, he doesn't have to worry about fucking copyright law.
And that, right? The town crier is where you get your posts. Yeah. Now it's time for a long read.
Just playing on his little lute. Yeah. There was a young lord with auburn hair.
Yeah. God, this is going to be the main character of the village. Yeah, go, go. Who is it? What do they do? Yeah, Sir Gawain. Yeah, idiot.
Fighting the Baron. One day he did dare. A bad mistake. For now he is dead. He's got a mace embedded in his head.
Whoa, went really hard there. You always think of the bards as being just very soft, very, very high throat voice, very high register.
We have no recordings.
I bet
some
of them just went dun dun dun.
Yeah, yeah.
And then he got stabbed. I like to think they all sound like northern boys.
Yeah. Also, there's no like worrying about like, oh, where's my royalties for streaming? It's only live shows.
And then at the end you go, okay. And it is more like live streams, right? Because they live on donations. And one donation they really want is, could someone give me a bed?
Yeah.
Oh, I really love that. Just getting in the chat now that actually Doreen from the Milk Churner's Hut has allowed me to stay. She's a married woman and her husband will be overseeing, and he will be sleeping with a sword by his bed.
Oh, really good news. I've got the patronage of a lord.
New patron just come through. It's the Earl. Shout out to the Earl.
Shout out to the Earl for letting me stay on his lands.
Yeah. Without the Earl, none of this would have been possible. Anyway, here's our next song, The Stupid Butcher Getting Maced in the Elbow.
Relationships, it's fucked because of the dating apps, people worrying about being ghosted, getting swiped left on. You don't have to worry about it. Your parents have arranged your marriage. They've gone, these kids are about the same age. We live next to each other. Done.
Yeah, that's so convenient. For you to marry anyone else would be insane.
Yes.
Sorry, you're going to marry someone from the town 2 miles down the road. Are you okay?
Hear ye, hear ye.
child wishes to marry someone from the poisoned sinners village of Welton.
Yes,
they've been platformed.
We've platformed a child for wanting to go to the village that, according to someone, is an adulterous village.
The Lord decides your wife.
Do you know? Would you rather, right, meet someone in the world and think you get on, we get on really well, I think there's a connection, and then you move beyond that, you form a relationship, you fall in love, you're mutually in love, and then a bit after that you're like, actually this hasn't worked out, we're both heartbroken, right? That's awful.
Yeah.
But if you're in an arranged marriage and you don't really get on, you think, well, you know, what did we expect?
Yeah, we can't imagine anything else.
I actually didn't come into this with a conception of love. I've never heard of that. I'm married to you so that we can share our labours and our children. Have you been reading French books or something? I don't know what you're talking about. We're married so that, you know, you can churn the butter and I'm going to hit this with a big hammer.
Yeah.
And what then more do you want from this relationship?
And we need to make more babies so the Lord can prosper.
Listen, at some point, by mutual agreement, we should have sex, if only because I think it's going to be a hard winter.
Yeah.
And then if you, I want there to at least be a three-year-old a few years down the line who can help me pull out the turnips.
No, no, so it's very likely two out of three of our children are going to die, so we've got to keep going.
Yeah, we've got to play the numbers.
Yeah. You know, sometimes you're like, what am I wearing today? Right.
Yeah.
Partly that's a personal thing of like, oh, you know, how should I look? Wouldn't it be good to just not worry about that? Wouldn't it be good to not worry about the exploitation of workers in the global supply chain and the reinforcement of class divides through consumerism and commodity fetishism that we see in fashion? Fast fashion. Fuck it. No. You have a sort of coarse tunic you wear from when you're big enough to get in it at the age of 12, when you stop growing because of malnourishment. And you wear it till you die.
Taking it off only briefly to go into a lake and to get bitten by ticks. Ready for your tick bath today? Yeah, let me just take off the tunic that has been welded to my skin through 4 months of constant wear.
Sustainable fashion.
It is sustainable.
Mm.
Because it actually biodegrades while you're still wearing it.
Mm.
So you know you're ready for a new one because the other one has literally returned back to its raw materials.
You're wearing compost.
Yeah, you are literally composting it.
Peasants always farming.
They're always farming. I am the soil for my top.
Everyone has been bombarded with advertising and manipulative tool that fosters false needs and materialism and the commodification of everyday life, diverting our attention from systemic inequalities and exploitation and wasting the labor of millions of people who work in the advertising industry making this shit. Oh, the only advert that should exist is a person outside the bakery going,
anyone want bread?
I think the only advert that I want to see is a printing press stamped list of grievances against the Catholic Church that I then share in secret with the guy who presses the wax for my candles.
No, fuck that. No, no. There's no. This is a no printing press feudalism episode. Handwritten only. I want I want the first letter of everything I read to be massive and have a dragon on it.
Okay, well, it's probably going to be done by the church, so I guess we're not going to get any. Nevertheless, I think I could probably hear about a rude tale about a foolish man who lived in the 1300s that is really in itself just kind of a moral principle about why not to be silly. But I can subvert it, right? I can read it non-critically.
Yeah.
Like the people who think Walter White's really cool. I could read one of these little follies about a silly knight and be like, this guy's
Gregor
my hero.
Looked down the dark, dark hole.
Gregor the Unwise. And I'm like, underneath my corner of the house where we all live in, I've scratched into the plastic, so I don't have posters or anything. I've just written in like, I love Gregor. Gregor rules.
You've scratched into the Mottl and Daub a crude image of Gregor looking down the hole, and then you've written next to it in a crude writing you barely understand, that's me.
Me. You have had to invent in your head what Gregor looks like. You depict him with materials you can get from rotten fruit, and then you scratch into the dirt, me. And then someone else sees it and be like, well, that could be anyone.
Yeah.
Both the depiction and the me.
Yeah.
I've lived barging to the front of the bards, being like, do Sir Gregor. So you want to be about Sir Gregor the stupid knight? Yeah, that's me. I relate to him.
Housing's fucked. 100%. Can we agree? So having a place to live, absolute horror show. Gentrification, displacement of the working class. Just people are working 30 years to pay off debt because houses aren't for living their commodities.
Complete lack of incentive and a complete lack of like political will just to build new houses to house the people who cannot be sheltered.
And you know what? It's quite hard to build a house. Like you and I could not build a house. But I tell you what, if I was shown by my parents how to use mottle and daub, and I could just find some land that the Lord let me have as long as I gave him half of the turnips I harvested.
And that there was always at least four strong men just sat on the grass doing nothing, looking big for labour.
And yeah. You go like, look, lads, it's winter. We're not farming. Help me get some wood and straw and shit and build a hut that's about 10 foot wide and fucking stinks. And we'll live in it with the pigs.
And we can all just live in it with the pigs. And next year, if things are going well, we'll build a chair.
And then we'll look at the pig. And if it gives us the right eye contact, we'll go, he's ready to die.
Yeah, we need consent. And that is a hard line for me, boys.
Yeah.
The pig must be on board with
his own
death.
The pig has to want to die.
Yeah, we if the pig are has anything
building
done,
mottle and daub pig dignitas. Pignitas.
If I get any sense this pig might come back as a ghost, we are just letting the pig die of old age. It cannot have any tasks left undone in the mortal realm.
You don't even have to pay insurance, because if your house burns down, you probably rebuild it in a day.
It's always raining as well.
Yeah, you don't have to worry about damp, because damp is everywhere. You have no concept of an absence of damp. Oh, my house has got rising damp. Has it? It's made of shit and sticks.
But it's good, right? You can be like, oh, it's raining and the rain's coming through all of the thatching and it's coming through like the rudimentary plaster I made that has loads of cracks and holes in it. Great, now I can put the candles on and know it's not going to burn the place down. There's always a silver lining. Let's get this place lit up. People from around the town, just there's like beams of light coming out of your cottage. It's the most brightest thing they've ever seen.
Transport system. We've been through how fucked cars are in a recent episode. Mm. You know, again, the prioritisation of profit over accessibility and sustainability fucks transport. We don't think about public transport infrastructure. The oil, global oil industry. Here's a solution. Feudalism. Option one, don't go anywhere.
Yeah, and that is, I think for most people, plan A.
That's plan A. Plan B, an oxen or a mule.
Well, I think there's also, the plan B for most people is don't go very far.
Don't go too far.
You can do it by foot.
Yeah, and you have to remember where you're going. There's no map. If you go too far and you get lost, that's a real problem.
Oh, you're gone. You're gone.
If you venture and if you take a couple of wrong turns, I think you could be fucked.
Yeah, because a lot of people are very illiterate, and I think some people won't even know the name of their town.
Yeah.
So where were you? Oh, it had three buildings and had a butcher's, and we churned milk by a little dirt path that we'd... and they'll be like, that's everywhere we've ever heard of. I can't help you. I bet there's a lot of people who died homeless and penniless about a 4-mile walk from where their house and family are.
Yeah, because the town crier couldn't understand their regional dialect.
Yeah, couldn't understand. So you're calling it a dusted. We call it a busted.
And everyone's very healthy because they're just walking everywhere. If you go in somewhere, you're walking. They've all got amazing calves. Yeah. Without gym membership, there's not some separate thing you're paying to go to get fit. You are fit because you're grafting in the fields all day. And then if you go into the next village to purchase an ox, you've walked.
If you are still alive, if you make it to adulthood, your immune system is going to be some of the strongest. If any adult from our time went back to feudalism, instantly dead. Because they had worse, you know, we had MMR vaccines of a little bit of stuff. They had full doses of literally everything.
Yeah.
They would have been, when you get born, there's going to be smallpox in the bed with you. So if you're getting past that, you're going to be hench, right? Your white blood cells are going to be the size of like of armbands.
And also there's no like global, you know, super commodified, globalized healthcare. No, you're not worrying about like, can Pfizer be trusted? You're just going to a local wise woman and see, and her solution to most stuff is slap some leeches on it.
Either blood out or eat this flower. Blue flower, it's very beautiful.
If you survive the treatment, it worked, great. If you die, dead, you've got nothing to worry about.
If you die, it's divine providence. And if you're cured, you are very welcome. And your family owe me a blood debt.
10 years later.
I'm here to collect the baby.
One baby, please.
One baby.
But why do you even need my baby? Potion.
Don't you remember, boy? I called you. It's not your space to ask questions of me.
Oh, but you're a baby in my porridge.
I'll be young forever.
I'll eat his youth. With
hear
half
ye,
an apple core.
Hear ye. Local woman platformed for eating baby.
Local woman regains youth, instantly killed.
Mandatory Redistribution Party was woven by the hands of Sean Morley and Jack Lewis Evans. The enchanting symphony that graced your ears at the beginning and right now was conjured by the bard Elegine. We offer our deep gratitude for thy devoted ears and offer special commendations to those souls who champion our cause by spreading word of Mandos across the realms, real and cyber, or by pledging your support at patreon.com/mandatoryredistributionparty, where a treasure trove of extraordinary extras awaits thee. Till next time, may fortune favour thy path.